Howdy, swim fans. Here's another episode of Whiteboard Wednesday. And on today's episode, we're discussing the 400 individual medley. Love it or hate it, the 400 IM is considered one of the most difficult and grueling races of the entire Olympic schedule. In this video, we're gonna talk about how you should race the 400 IM and different things you can do in training so that you can maximize your full potential in this difficult event. Now to start, IM is short for individual medley. There's four parts of the medley, and in a 400 IM, you swim them butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and freestyle. There's three different versions of the IM. There's the 400 IM, the 200 IM, and the 100 individual medley. Only the 200 and 400 IM are contested at the Olympic Games and in long course competition. If you take away anything from this video, it is the main concept that we're about to discuss, which is that to swim a successful 400 individual medley, you have to think about negative splitting each segment of the event. In other words, if we treat a 400 IM as four distinct 100s, 100 butterfly, 100 backstroke, 100 breaststroke, 100 freestyle, if we take each 100 segment and we cut them in half, our goal is to negative split by time and by feel every single 50. In other words, we want the second 50 to be stronger than the first 50. The only exception to this is the first 50 because you're fresh, you have a dive, and of course you're gonna be swimming faster on the first 50 butterfly than you will on the second. But for each of the remaining three 100s, the 100 backstroke, 100 breaststroke, and 100 freestyle, your goal is to actually negative split by feel and by time. In other words, you'll build the first 50 and then swim strong on the second 50. And the best athletes in the world can do this to such a high degree of accuracy every single time they do the event. For you, depending on how many times you've raced the 400 individual medley, this will come with practice. But the goal, again, if you take nothing away else from this video, is that you should focus on negative splitting every segment of the IM. And this also applies in the 200 individual medley as well, although not as much. In the 400 IM, it's so difficult because you have the aerobic distance training that's required so that you don't die on each of these different segments, but it's also an anaerobic event because you're swimming essentially fast for four 100s. And the reason why you negative split every single 100 is so that way you can conserve your energy appropriately while maxing out as much as you can out of each stroke before transitioning to the next stroke. It also prevents you from having a lot of stroke deficiencies and spinning your wheels on the first part of each stroke transition. If you go too fast on the first 50 backstroke, for example, you'll be dead by the second 50 backstroke and your race can only deteriorate from there. If we look at the best swimmers in the world, and I have two, for example, Michael Phelps and Katinka Hosszú, the two current world record holders in the 400 individual medley, we're gonna overview how they split every 50 of the race, and we'll take a look at how they negative split each 100. If we look at Michael Phelps first, the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing, where he swam a 403.8, absolutely incredible. For reference, he first broke the world record in this event in 2002, where he took it from a 411 down to a 403 by the Beijing Olympic Games. If we look at his splits, out in a 25.7 on the fly, back in a 29.1, remember, we're not expecting to negative split the first 100, but you should always be building into the next transition. And so even though he was a few seconds slower on the second 50 of the butterfly, by effort, he was definitely trying much, much harder on the second 50. And the first 50 was all easy, natural speed. He had a 12% difference between these two 50s. He was 12% slower on the second 50 than the first 50. Now, if we look at his backstroke, he split 31.3, 30.2. He had a negative split of 4% between the two 50s. His breaststroke, 34.7, 35.7. Now, this doesn't follow the pattern, but in breaststroke, if it's your weakest stroke, this is extremely difficult to negative split. And even the best in the world, Michael Phelps and Katinka Hosszú, failed to actually negative split. But by effort, they're definitely trying harder and they're really focusing on swimming a stronger second 50. But if it's not your stroke and it's long course, you might have a fatigue, like a 3% increase at the head. On the freestyle, 28.9 to 27.8. That's a negative 4%, 4% negative split. And in cumulatively, his swim on every split, he was faster than every other athlete in the water. So even though he failed to negative split, the whole point here is that he's negative splitting by effort, and ideally you're doing it by time. If you look at short course swimming in yards and in meters, most swimmers have a negative split across the back, breast, and the free. Now if we look at Katinka Hosszú from Hungary, world record holder in the 400 individual medley from the 2016 Rio Olympic Games, she swam a 426.3, out in 28.3, back in 32.5, similar to Phelps with a 13% increase. But again, that's to be expected. Easy speed on the first 50, really negative splitting, a lot stronger on the second 50. The backstroke, 34.1, 33.3. So she had a 2% negative split. Michael had a 4% negative split. The breaststroke, 37.2, 38.8. That's a 4% increase. Again, Katinka and Michael are the weakest in their breaststroke, and this is long course again, so there's a bigger fatiguing period on the breaststroke. The freestyle, 31.1, 30.6. That's a 2% negative split. And as you can see, Michael actually has a more aggressive negative split. And you could argue that Michael could have theoretically have gone even faster in this race if he had pushed it a little bit more on the first 50 and had maybe even less of a negative split. You could also counter that with the fact that this was the first of 17 Olympic swims in the 08 Olympics where he won 8 for 8 gold medals. So maybe he was being strategic with his energy. Now, how can you apply this in your racing and in your training? The first tip I have for you in the 400 IM is to have the right mindset. If you don't have the right mindset about your training, because it's going to be hard. The 400 IM training and racing is extremely grueling, and to be successful at it, you have to really want to be good at it. So I say number one is actually having the right mindset in training and in competition, and no matter how hard the workouts are, you stick to it and you focus on these different things we're about to talk about. Number two is this negative split mentality. You have to approach every single training session, every single set, even if the coach or the instructions of the workout doesn't say negative split, you should always be thinking about how can I negative split this by effort or and or by time. So even if you're doing a 500, then second 250 needs to be faster than the first 250. Thinking about easy speed. You don't want to ever force your speed. If you want to be good in the individual medley, whether that's a 200 or a 400, the best swimmers in the world are able to go out in a 25, 28, whatever the time is, they're not actually trying very hard. It's easy speed, and the way you develop that is in workout. Don't force it. Really focus on technique and applying that easy speed so that way you have a lot of energy conserved for the rest of the race. Train all of the strokes to be good at the 400 IM. And I have the 200 dot, dot, dot. If you wanna be a really good 200 or even 400 individual medley swimmer, you have to be good at the 200 of every single stroke. The 200 IM is a little bit different. If you're good at the 100 of every stroke, you can get away with being really competitive in the 200 IM. But the best swimmers like a Michael or a Katinka are world class in the 200s of every single stroke. Michael Phelps' worst stroke is breaststroke, and he's still a world-class swimmer in the 200 breaststroke. So if you focus on improving your 400 IM, you have to train all of the strokes. And in addition to training the strokes, you have to train IM. But don't just train a lot of individual medley. I'm not saying go do 5 400 IMs or 10 400 IMs. Train FRIM. FRIM means you take out the butterfly, and if it was 100, you'd go 25 freestyle, 25 backstroke, 25 breaststroke, 25 freestyle. Try transition IM, which is in the main set we're about to talk about. Try reverse IM, where you put the butterfly at the back. Separate the fly from your aerobic training. So have a set dedicated solely to butterfly and do a set solely dedicated to aerobic mixed training where you do FRIM. So maybe you have 50s butterfly and then you'll have a whole nother set that's focused on FRIM. No butterfly, but you'll have freestyle, backstroke, and breaststroke. And finally, focus on your weakest stroke. If you want to improve your 400 IM or your 200 IM or your 100 IM, the fastest way to get better is to actually improve the worst stroke in your arsenal. So if you're really bad at breaststroke, it does you no good to keep working on your backstroke. when the breaststroke can be an area that you can easily improve, and then the other parts of your IM will actually improve because you're less fatigued on that specific segment of the race. So always focus on your worst stroke when you're trying to improve the IM. Now, we have an example workout here on the board. Now, this workout is 3,500 meters, and it takes about 75 minutes to complete. And again, based on your skill level, you'll want to modify this to be a little bit shorter or a little bit longer. But this workout is really designed for a swimmer who's focusing on the 200 or the 400 individual medley, and they're focused on improving this negative split concept. So let's go through it. The 400 is your warm-up, 400 freestyle, nice and easy cruise, followed by 12 75s, kick, drill, swim, in IM order. In other words, what that means is you'll go a 25 kick, dolphin kick, a 25 drill, butterfly drill, and then a 25 butterfly swim. The second one, you'll do backstroke, kick, backstroke, drill, backstroke, swim, breaststroke, kick, breaststroke, drill, breaststroke, swim. You'll go through that freestyle and you'll do that three rounds on the 130. Now the main set is what I really want to focus on. The main set is essentially four 100s transition IM split up between two 200 IMs interlaid within the set. That didn't make a lot of sense, but I'll make sure that you understand by the end of this. So four 100s where you go 50 fly, 50 backstroke. Those are on the 145 and you're focusing on negative splitting. So you're swimming faster on the second 50 backstroke than the first 50 butterfly. Then you'll go a 200 IM cruise on the 4 minute, and you're focusing on having really perfect strokes. You're negative splitting by 25. This can be done in either long course or short course. 75s you'll have to modify if you're in your long course. Then you'll go four 100s, 50 backstroke, 50 breaststroke. Again, you're negative splitting. So you go 50 back, 50 breast, negative split on the 145. Then you do another 200 IM, focus on negative splitting, and your 200 IM here should be faster than your first one. The last part of the main set is four 100s, 50 breaststroke, 50 freestyle on the 145. Again, negative splitting. So you want to finish stronger. Goes back to that concept of negative splitting everything that you do. Now, the best part of this set, after you've really aerobically warmed up your body, and you shouldn't take any break, if you're trying to train for the 400 IM, you don't take any break between any of the sets within the main set. After the main set, regroup, recover, and you're gonna go a 400 IM broken in the form of 850s IM order by two. So you go 50 fly, 50 fly, 50 back, 50 back. Two 50s of each stroke. These will be on the minute, and you're trying to mimic what it would feel like and pace to do a 400 IM. You're focused on negative splitting. So ideally, if you were Michael, maybe you're doing this in short course yards to go a 403, you know, maybe you can go a 25, you'll dive in on the first one, and you're gonna try and go even faster than a 29 because you're not doing it continuous. Go a 27. On the backstroke, 31, 30. On the breaststroke, try and hit 34, 33. On the freestyle, 28, 27. The goal is to negative split the second 50 to be faster than the first 50. And after that, you'll go 5 100s freestyle, cool down, flush out the lactic acid. So although the 400 IM is the most difficult event in the program, in my opinion, some will put it against the 200s of stroke or the mile. The mile is often the most contended against the 400 IM. Either way, they're all very difficult events, but if you focus on the 400 IM, if you remember one thing, it's the concept of negative splitting each segment of the 400 IM, so that way the first 50 or the first 25 is a build, and the second 50 or second 25 holds strong. That'll allow you to maintain the best technique throughout the duration of the race and really maximize your potential in that specific event. That was Whiteboard Wednesday, and this was the 400 individual medley how-to video. We'll catch you guys later. Bye.